Draw the knees in towards the chest. Let's take the bolster away now. Come back to the centre and then extend the right leg up. Just put your hands behind your legs somewhere. Just ease it towards you, ease it towards your face. And then we're going to swap. So we're going to do it with the breath. So on the inhale, you're going to release the leg, straighten the other one. Moving and not breathing or thinking about the breath, you're doing it mindfully with the breath. You could also start to extend the bent leg away from the floor if that feels better. Depends on your hamstrings. Your legs or however it's comfortable. You can do Baddha Konasana if you prefer, or cross the legs, but I'm going to do Baddha Konasana. Especially if you've got knee issues going on, might be better. So adjust your feet so that your knees feel comfortable and your hips, and then just bounce. So little pulses. Keep we don't want this arched back like this. We want just a nice straight back if we can. For this pose, you can do a folded down version. I want you to feel as if you're tilting from your hips. Did you feel that?
Yeah.
Do you not normally do that? What do you think?
I don't know. My hips aren't terribly good anyway.
No.
They're very stiff.
Yeah.
But yes, if I lift myself up and then go over.
You lift yourself up. So that's a one sort of little tip that I do when I'm wanting to, I need a bit of help, although I'm not forcing it, but I'm sort of holding my feet. Coming forwards, breathing in, so you'll lift up, you know, so you're open, and then breathe out, try not to go down too low, just a little movement forwards, and then let yourself sort of go back up again. Again, this is a bit like a little pulsing action, and you'll find, we'll just keep maybe in your 10, 20 breaths like that. You might feel it starts to kind of open a little bit more. Come a little bit lower, maybe. So then, if you feeling like you can come down lower, like okay, your elbows are now starting to come a little bit further forwards. So you could, you know, move the arms like this, or you could just allow yourself to not, you're just kind of wiggling around a little bit, just releasing the back and the hips. Just watch your knees. Sometimes in this pose, if you were holding it, so if people have got, you could wedge each, if you've got a block, you can kind of wedge.
Do you want to ensure you have a block?
No, I'm fine, I just can't get out of it.
Yes, see, it's
done. Okay, let's move them.
It's fine.
Okay, so let's do straight legs. I'm just giving them a bit of a shake.
Sorry.
No, I don't. So we're going to come onto the knees now. Let's move them a little bit. So go side to side. Just kind of get into that juicy hip that you can feel it kind of quite tight. And then you can start to rock, you know, forwards, so tilting the pelvis. So I like to sort of do a kind of cat, slight cat, you know, like cat when you come up. So you go side, push up through the hands, so you're stretching the back, upper back, and then over to the other side. And just play around with that, see how that feels. And then maybe add, start to add a circle. Or half a circle. Start with half a circle, right, going from the right, round to the back to the left. And bring a bit of weight into the arms as well. So kind of bring the hips forward slightly as well. So just do that a couple more times and then we'll start to come forwards. So we do a full circle. So almost like you're coming into an up dog, but maybe not quite. Or maybe starting to come into a child's pose. or settle in one of those poses, like child's pose or even up dog. And then we're going to move through the moon flow. So coming from child's pose, arching up, dropping hips, shoulders start to come back, and then the head lifts. Don't come down too low. If you want, you can bring your bolster in front to support you here. If you need it. And just move however feels nice. So I do like this kind of spiraling movement. And this is supposed to sort of shift blocked energy. Even in the chakras, sort of blockage in the chakras, kind of flushes it out. And they do say that sometimes, well, you know, if you have got a block in an area in your chakra, it can manifest as a physical stiffness or, you know, tightness. Let's do it together. Let's do three together a little bit faster now. So we're going to come up, breathing in, breathing out. Breathing in, come back. Breathe out in child's pose. If you want to, you could chaturanga arms, you could scoot down and up. Let's do another one of those actually. Exhale back. And again, inhaling up. We push through the shoulder, hands and shoulders. Lower down carefully, connecting your back. Inhaling up. Okay, tuck the toes under. Let's stretch out the feet. So, toes under. Push back with your bottom.
Oh, God. Are you alright?
Oh,
bloody hell.
That was just, by the way, on camera. That was Kate's knee.
Sorry, I'm
Did that hurt?
It was not at all.
Okay, so make sure you've got space on your mat. You might have to shuffle forwards for the next one. We're going to come up onto hands and knees and then just send the right leg back. Take my socks off, it's slippy. Warmed up now. I've been in the woods all day.
Ooh, nice.
Really chilly. So push back through the heels so you can just get a stretch in the calf. wait for it to release a bit. Swap. Swap sides. Really press as much as you can back into the tight calves, everybody. This is a good one. You could do it at home. I've got a new little move for you, actually. Went to a class yesterday. I actually went to a live class. I haven't done for ages. So we're going to do that again. I'm just going to show you, because we haven't done this before. So we start like this, pushing back. We're going to breathe in, bring the knee forwards. Now, I'm hoping you won't have to do this. And then you lean, push your bottom back. And then you bring it back. Slide it back, and then we swap. So let's start with the right leg. Okay, so I'm going to breathe in, bring it forward as much as you can, see if you can slide it forwards and then to the back. So it's like eagle legs, you know how we do eagle legs? Really squeeze the legs together, knees, and then lean back so you want to feel it in your buttock and hip. And then come back. So it's supposed to be a bit of a flow, but we can hold it in a minute. So send that like that. Inhale up. Exhale, cross. Inhale. Exhale, stay. And then bring it back. And swap. We'll do one more. And then we might hold one more after that and hold. Quite strange feeling. Okay, the next one, I'm going to hold it in that position just a few breaths. See if you can kind of lean back. Slide it in front of the bent knee, squeeze the knees together and then lean back, push your bottom back. Try and keep your weight central, not be leaning too much on one side, although you do a little bit. Maybe feel the difference, so you can kind of like rock slightly left to right, just sort of feel where you get the most stretch. Changes. Okay, and then bring the leg back. Come into child's pose. And then we're going to get off the knees. So we're going to come up into down dog. Stretch it out. Pedal feet. Knee two. Kneel back again. And then here you can do whatever you like. Stay in down dog, so spread your feet, make sure your hands, shoulder apart, spread your fingers, try and get the weight off the heel of your hands. If you want to, you can lift up one leg into three-legged dog. You could open out the hip if you like. Sending that foot behind you, look under your arm, same arm. Same arm that you're lifting, not the opposite one. And then bring it back to the other one. If it's too much, just same down dog. We'll just do it for a little moment. It might be too much on your hands or your wrists. Good, and then bring it down. And then you're going to walk either your hands to feet or your feet to your hands. Whichever is easier. Bend the knees. I want you to take the feet a bit wider. Bend the knees. Gentle bounces if that feels nice. And then start to straighten the legs a little bit. Again, you don't have to straighten them completely, remember. Just become like a rag doll. Try and let the upper body even just move the arms, move the shoulders, release everything, neck. Okay, and I'm going to slowly lift up, keep your knees bent. Until you come to a standing position. Just take the arms, just open them. Keep the arms soft. I'm just going to keep everything soft today. I'm going to go the other way. Okay, so let's start coming at the top of the mat. I'm completely a silhouette. I don't know if anyone's going to be able to see anything because I'm just like, there's a light behind me because it's black. Things. I don't know if it's working and my head keeps disappearing. So sorry. Anyway, I'm getting a very professional video. I'm going to go this way on the camera. So, hands together. Remember, soften the legs a little bit. Think of strength. You want to feel strong. But kind of grounded, you can't be pushed over. Come here. In fact, if you put one hand on your tummy and one hand on your lower back, and then go forwards and backwards. I've got a curve here. My tummy sticks out, you can feel it, can't you? When you put your hand there. But actually, if it helps when you put your hand, kind of like tilt, can you feel that? So go tilt all the way forwards and then go back, forwards, back, and then see if you can find the middle. Yeah? So with teacher yesterday was talking a lot about how we all walk a bit like got our heads forwards and our hips out, and how we get backache, you know, if you're walking the wrong way, particularly. And that the best thing someone told her was standing against a wall and putting the head back, which we find hard, right? And actually, you should walk like that. That's how you should walk. So that was the best tip. She's got scoliosis, and that was the best tip that she's ever been told. And she's a yoga teacher. And she was telling us the story about how she lost a bit off her necklace. She walked 8 kilometres with her dog, lost this really special thing on her necklace, and had to retrace her steps to 8 kilometres like this, looking for this thing on the floor. And she said she'd done the 8 kilometres normally, walking straight. Because she was like that, your head is so heavy that she's had really bad backache ever since.
Did she find it?
No. But she said she learned a lesson to never looking at the ground. So if you're watching this, find a wall, stand against it. Your bottom probably feels, you've got a big bum like me. you can really feel like. Yeah, it's hard to get your to be flat. But that's apparently where your head should be stacked. Which feels all the way back, doesn't it? Feels quite straight. And try and keep that, and then walk forwards. And come to the arm. Do a few steps, and then walk. So, without trying to tilt forwards, which your head kind of comes forwards, maybe don't even go so far as you normally would. Just see, you could just alternate a hand every time, so whichever way you're going, that hand grabs the wrist. Already leaning forwards. There, then I come back. Let's try Trikonasana against the wall. So both legs are straight. You might not be able to go completely against the wall. So your front foot is facing forwards and your back foot is facing out into the room. Yeah, see if you can. I can't get my feet completely to touch the floor because of my bottom. And I haven't got much space, that's not going to work here, is it? So you're tilting
the hip, is that right?
Yeah. So you're pushing this opposite hip out. So which way are you going? So you're pushing your right hip out. And you're doing your right hip as well. You try and keep the head on the floor and just slide the hand down until you feel like you can't get any more. Interesting. Then swap sides, we won't stay over too long. Then swap your feet the other way. Feet towards me, you two. And coming. Another one to practice at home. It is hard. We haven't warmed up completely, but come onto the mat now and then see how that feels on the mat. So you'll probably notice what you probably do is you come forwards.
Yeah.
your back, your foot nearest me, point towards me. Then step back, but it's not as wide as a warrior two. It's just a little bit, it's about a warrior one feet, really. And then hip, push the hip out. Reach forwards. Now roll this. What I would suggest is this to this shoulder here. Keep your hand on your hip or the back of your hand and open. Like pull it back. They feel different. Because you're either leaning backwards or leaning forwards. Yeah. So you can do the other side. So just spin the other way. Try and get your, see the heel on the front foot. See if you can draw a line so that it's in the heel is in like the middle of your back foot. So you could stand on your lines on your mat. Perfect. Perfect for that.
Fire.
Take your legs wide, point your toes forwards, pigeon toe them a bit. So toes in, heels out. Knee issues, bend the knees a little bit, okay? Now I want you to kind of fold from the hips. Hands on your hips, push your bottom back first. Go slow so you can feel it. Push your back. Again, you're folding from your hips, not your back. Down a little bit lower. Notice that. Good. Tell me something in her head. Okay, now spread your toes. Strong pressure through the feet. Gauge your legs and then push yourself up. And then do that again. So take your arms up this time. Breathe in. Stretch up through the right side. On the left. Just alternating. So I'm holding my hand. Can't see that in the video. Good. And then lastly, come to the centre. Reach up. Look up towards your hands. Breathe in. Exhale. Bring hands to your hips. Let's do that again. Push, go really slowly, bend the knees slightly, just ever so slightly, push the bottom back, flat back, so if you can get that flat back, as long as you can, and then you can release everything. You can put your hands on your feet, with your ankles if you like, or grab your big toes, bind, drop your head, give your head a bit of a shake. Body go. How does it be? to walk your hands in front of you, so now to your shoulders. Could maybe go a little wider if it feels okay, or you might want to stay the same. So your hands are straight, arms are straight. So breathe in and look, so past your hands, so you're still looking at the floor, but look forwards. And then you exhale, and bend the elbows, and see if you come down a little more on the exhale. You're pulsing again, inhaling up, straightening arms. So it's just the arms. Exhale. If you're coming down quite low, you don't have to straighten the arms. You just come lifting up, like you're looking forward. So it's a bit like when we're doing a Baddhakonasana, you know, you're looking forwards, breathing in and breathing out, focusing on the hips and the pelvis. Just feel, notice if you can feel like it's just releasing a little bit. And then when you feel ready to just hold it, whichever position, you just hold it for a few breaths. Me, you're both facing slightly different ways, and come into a lunge. So turn the front foot and the back foot. I'm going to drop the knee down and make sure you can feel a stretch here. I just want you just to explore this. Go, I want you to, it might be just a very small movement for you. It's a little bit of a variation on the dragon. So this is the dragon. Can you open, can you let your front knee drop out to the side and your foot roll at the front? You might not, if it doesn't feel right on your knee. Yeah, good. Now, can you roll and drop the right hip a bit? Good. Now, if you're feeling strongish, then you've got your hand in the right place, so your opposite hand to your foot, could you lift up the hand closest to your foot? Could you lift it off the floor?
It really hurts my wrist there. Is it in there?
Turn it out. If it hurts, you can turn it out.
It's the
way. No? Okay, don't do it then. Keep both hands on the floor. If it feels okay, you could bring the arm up and over. What you could do is bring your bolster here. And then you might find you haven't got as much weight. But maybe. So it might be too strong. If it is, just this is still good. Just coming forwards. Does that feel? Does that feel a bit better?
It's okay. If it's just this
too much. Yeah.
It's a big weight.
Or you put your hand on the bolster. Would that work?
Just about do this, man.
Yeah. Don't do it for long. So just a few sweeps of the arms, and then we're going to swap. So we're going to swap sides. If that's too much, just keep it forwards. Keep it forwards, keep it still. Just work on the lunge. That is still good. Just might not suit everybody to open out. So the other option is to put the hand on the knee and then stay at that side.
It is, it's still not, the wrists are not particularly happy that this wrist is with.
I'm going to do your wrist exercise in a minute.
Okay.
Okay, if you love seeing, you want to, do your arms. If your hands are on the floor, roll onto a little finger and then bring the fingers in to maybe make a fist and then roll it around. And then back and do the same with that one.
Oh gosh.
Don't have to lean, don't press so hard maybe. Kind of like a roll.
Which way, outwards or inwards?
Onto the little finger.
Onto the little finger.
And then spin.
Spin it.
So I'm not pressing actually too hard. I'm not. Interesting, isn't it?
I think that's mouse work, isn't it?
Yeah, probably.
Computers.
And of course the other ones that we do, which are really not very nice.
I can't do those.
No.
Cringe.
Yeah.
No way.
No.
When you do that, can you put weight on it? Because I can do it, but if I put weight on it, it's excruciating.
They're ones to just work on, just to do a little bit every day, is that I've got the same sort of feeling with my feet. In certain positions. But no, it's very tight. But some people can lift the fingers up.
What, with weight on them?
Yeah.
So I can lift the fingers up, but I haven't got
much weight.
I'm bouncing my weight.
No, up. I haven't got much weight. Okay, and then the other way is this way. When you sit back, probably is.
Yeah, it makes the tendon stretch.
Makes it feel stretchier.
Yeah, more stretchy.
Mm. So you can play around with forwards, backwards.
Backwards.
Poor little wristies. So we're going to do a nice, a little restorative twist. Remember this one?
Yes.
Favourite. So if you haven't got a bolster, you could get a cushion. Maybe you don't need the bolster, or you could just hold it. If you haven't got a bolster, maybe just into that sort of position. If you have, or you can find something at home, just lie on. So we're trying to get the centre of the chest into the bolster. And that bolt is coming into the hip here. And then you can change the angle depending on how far you can turn and twist. So sometimes it's helpful to sit up first and turn, lift up and turn, lift up and turn, and then lie down.
Do that the way.
That feels better, yeah, doesn't it? So I could, I don't think I could. I've not actually tried it to be honest. Never thought of that time.
I think it's because my body's too short up and over the bus.
Yeah.
Or the floor.
You could always like put a blanket, couldn't you? Just like that's too there. Pad it up, yeah, have a smaller, but you've got something to lie on and put your face on.
Yeah.
Maybe even the rolled up yoga mat would be quite good, you know, something like that, or a foam bolster, you know, like bed ones that you can get. Weight is on one side more, see if you can even it up a little bit. You might be after you've lied here for a little bit and laid here for a little bit, you can come up slightly and twist a little bit more, move a little bit more over, or come flatter. And start to think about easing yourself up very slowly. You're going to feel quite stiff. Careful, just come up without moving your legs, just so you can sit up and then twist the other way. So you can sort of put, maybe hold your foot or your hand on the thigh, just help sort of counter twist, counter pose. Swap your knees round. You're just going to go the other side. We did that.
Okay.
You should have gone that way. Turn that way.
Move the bolster that way.
No, you don't have to move the bolster if you did what I just suggested. Move the legs the other way. How are they? Now come to That's it. I was trying to make it easy for you, so you don't have to move the bolster. You do have to move the angle of the bolster, though, obviously. You have to move it and find. So first of all, sit up, then turn. Turn as far as you can. Turn, turn. And when you can't turn anymore, get the bolster and sort of line it up as you come down. And adjust if you need to. You can play around with your legs as well, so you could send the back leg. Some people can't feel this so much. If they're not stiff this way, so you might need to play around with sending the back leg, straightening the top leg, or sending the hip back a little bit. Sinking into the shape. Try and even out your arms a little bit, leaning more to the right or the left. Last breath. And very slowly start to ease yourself up. Remember your counter pose. Sliding the hand with the opposite knee. Maybe looking behind you. Ready? ready for Shavasana. Just do any little stretches that you just need to do before lying down, maybe side to side, or maybe knees into the chest. Maybe happy baby pose. Take a few sighs, if you like, just to help relax you. In your mind, just go down to the feet, let your feet drop out to the side, let them flop. Let the legs also flop from the hips. You don't want to be holding on to any tension at all. If you're feeling any discomfort anywhere or any tension still, just focus your mind to that area. Breathe in and send that breath to that area. And then breathe out and relax the area. Just do it a few times. It could be physical thing, it could be in your head. It could be a feeling. Thank you. Okay, just start to bring yourself back. So bring some movement into your body. Slowly fingers, toes, wrists, ankles. And then take a whole body stretch. Slowly going over to one side, bring yourself up to seated position. Take a nice breath in. Bring the shoulders up to your ears, give them a squeeze. Your hands to your heart center. Namaste.